Hi, this is Melody Wilson with the Real Life team at RE/MAX Elite. Today I'm coming to you with the December market stats. In the month of January, it is very cold, and we're just taking a look at what happened last month. And in a little bit, I'll do a whole year review. So I want to talk to you about the condo market in Edmonton. We all know how lovely the condo market is. It's very specific in terms of what is selling and what is not selling. The condo market is very challenging. So when we look at the average price gone down, that is no surprise. The price month over month, year over year has gone down, but the number of sales in general have just gone down. Keep in mind, new condo sales aren't necessarily always recorded on MLS, so that kind of skews things. If people are buying brand new condos and basically not buying resale instead, all we see is the effect on the resale side in terms of how low everything's going because there's less sales. We don't see that what people are spending for the new stuff because it's not being recorded on MLS. So in the condo market in December, in terms of your odds of selling, it actually went up. Now, you kind of wonder why on earth did it go up. It went up by like very minimal amount, only because in the month of December there were less listings and there were actually a little bit more sold than the month prior. So some of the things I can think of, and I know we've done this with our clients, is in the month of December, if you're not really needing to sell your condo, we take the condo off the market. So there's a lot less listings on the market in December because people don't want to be bothered in December, and they know it's a slow market. They know that there's not a ton of buyers out there buying. So the buyers that were kind of humming and hawing, they did make their decisions in the month of December. So you can see that there were some increase, very slight, in the condo market. So that's kind of where and how I think those market stats make sense. So in the condo market, the average days on market is 81. The last time it was even remotely that high was in February at 92. So it usually stayed close to the high 60s, low 70s over the year. And why is the market taking longer and longer to sell? Well, I know one thing. When you price a condo below market value, which is technically market value, so if you think of something that sold in April, it is not gonna sell for the same thing that it does in November. So it is really difficult to sell. So even if you price it low, it still doesn't sell. There's still not people coming to your property. It's just no rhyme or reason, but there's a huge, I think, an explanation for it. Usually in the lower priced condos, you have high condo fees. So if you've got the high condo fees, why would you buy that price of condo when you can buy maybe a little bit higher? Or there's also the competition in the single family world that you can actually buy without buying a condo. So you as a condo owner, if you're buying a condo, I'm assuming you're buying it because of a lifestyle. You're buying it because you want the lifestyle of a condo owner and you understand the risks involved with buying a condo. So in that regards, makes sense for you to buy a condo. Prices are getting cheaper and cheaper. You gotta remember though, like they just announced this month, the deductible went up from $20,000 to $50,000 that you as a homeowner are liable for if by chance a pipe breaks in your unit. So make sure you talk to your home insurance to make sure you are covered for that deductible. But other than that, like condo market is a great time to buy, but not a great time to sell. So if you're wondering how the condo market is going to do in 2020, I don't think I have to be someone with a crystal ball. I'm pretty sure the market's gonna continue to decline. There's not as much promise for the condo market to recover because of the excessive amount of inventory and the new inventory being added at a really high rate. If you have any questions on selling your condo, whether you should be waiting until next year, 5 years, 10 years, what difference that's gonna make, or if you're just interested in what your condo is worth, just for the sake of knowing, give me a call and I'd be happy to help you. Thanks so much for tuning in and we'll talk to you next time.